International Khabar. I'm Shweta Ranjan, and today we have with us a very, very special guest. Yes, Jayanti Komaresh, a torchbearer worldwide for Saraswati Veena, the national instrument of India. An artist, a collaborator, composer, researcher, creator, and a pioneer in her field. Please allow me to welcome Jayanti Komaresh to the show. Welcome, Jayanti ji. How have you been?
I'm great. How are you, Shweta ji?
I am doing good. So yesterday we were having a very wonderful conversation, me and you. And you were saying that 2020, it seems, has not existed for us.
No doubt. I'm not counting this in my age.
Right. So you are not 50 yet?
I'll be next year, because if I take off this year, then next year.
No, because you look like a 20-year-old, believe me. I think music makes one look so charming and so beautiful.
Music is charming. I think the more we are in it, the more beautiful we try to become inside. And it's our duty as a musician to make everyone feel beautiful also.
Right. So, you've been associated with Saraswati Veena since your childhood. Teen saal ki thi aap us samay?
Haan, teen saal ki.
So, jab ek family mein, when you have so many violinists around you, then how did Saraswati Veena come in?
Jab main teen saal ki thi, my mother started me off on Saraswati Veena. I don't think I was old enough to make a choice कि मैं ये बजाऊंगी वो बजाऊंगी, पर कुछ अट्रैक्शन था. वो सरस्वती देवी के हाथ में सरस्वती वीणा था और कुछ अट्रैक्शन था, और मेरे माँ ने, शी डिसाइडेड आई शुड प्ले इट. आई वुड से रादर देन मी चूजिंग द वीणा, द वीणा चोज मी. एंड इट्स बीन अ ब्यूटिफुल रिलेशनशिप फ्रॉम द एज ऑफ 3. दो आई वॉज सराउंडेड बाई लेजेंड्स, ग्रेट वायलिनिस्ट्स. माई आंट मौसी, माई मदर्स एल्डर सिस्टर, she was the only veena player, which is in a family replete with violinists. And my mother started me off, and then I learned from my mausi.
Right. So how was it to live among the veena players? To live among the violinists, surrounded by violinists, so many of them. And after marriage, also, you married a violinist.
True. So, the entire length of the violin to play is just this much. Mine is 3 times, like you can see all the veenas here, the length I have to play. So, what they would do in a short flight journey, I have to take 3 flights to finish that journey. So, it was a challenge. Violin is smaller, easier, louder. Veena is, I'm not saying easier in terms of playing, easier to carry. Veena is big, and you have to work more to play what you can do in violin on the veena. But both these instruments are very unique in their own way. It's like comparing apples and oranges. So you can't actually, that is a bowed instrument, this is a plucked instrument, and very different. It felt very enriching to have these different sonic experiences, you know, from the violin, from everything, from my childhood, even before I was born. My mother is a very, very renowned violinist. So hearing so much music from childhood definitely gave me a new perspective in music.
So did you feel special being the only veena player in the family? It must be unique.
I don't know. Now I feel special that I'm playing on the veena. At that time, many people asked me, your uncle is such a giant among musicians. He's the legend, the great Lal Guri Jairamanji. So how come you're not playing the violin? How come you're playing the veena? So as I was growing up, several people asked me this question. It took me a lot of inner strength to stick to what I set out to do.
Right. So I would request the viewers to keep writing your comments if you have any. Please, viewers, send in your wishes, send in your comments, so that we will be able to include them during the conversation. And currently, we have Nandini Chandrasekhar with us saying, wow. And we have Prajna Adiga sending love, and Sudhashil Chatterjee writing excellent. Thank you, Sudhashil ji, and thank you all the audience and viewers. It boosts our, it motivates us to do better. So, further, after 3 years, you moved out and stayed with your auntie to learn when you were in your 8th standard. So, how was the 8th standard ka bachcha? Mujhe to lagta hai jaise bahut chota hota hai. To be staying away from family and learning something, how was it emotionally, mentally?
It was in every sense a gurukul. So it was not like you go, oh, summer vacation, I'll go with my auntie, have fun. No, not like that. She was, if discipline took a human form and came and stood in front of us, it was my aunt. It was my Guruji. She would wake you up at 4 o'clock, and then I would practice till around 7:30. The beauty is she will also wake up and then get ready, go to school, come back, immediately play another 2.5-3 hours. Then she will allow me to go and do my homework as if it was like, you know, a big gift she's giving me. Chalo, homework karo. Thoda der, baad mein aajana, play karne ke liye, you know. So it was like my holiday was doing my homework. And she didn't want me to go to regular day school. She preferred that I do homeschooling. But I wanted to definitely go to school and go to the regular thing and do. And somehow she'll make me play around 8 hours every day.
So, of course, I believe Sangeet was given more preference, was a most important thing than studies even in the family.
Yes, yes. Because it's 7 generations of musicians, no? So, it was expected that, and I had left my family and my parents and I said, I want to be a veena player, and I've come to her. So it was like she took it upon her. She sacrificed everything she could to make me, flourish as a veena player.
And because she did that, you are here today. You are...
Definitely.
So we have another very talented musician with us, sarod player Ranjit Sen Gupta.
Namaste, Ranjit ji. What an honor. How wonderful that he's here.
He writes, good evening, Jayanti ji. Good evening, Shweta ji. Dada, how are you? Kimon ashe? So, I just don't speak this much Bangla, so I'm trying to connect. And we have Vibha Masti sending hugs and love. And we have Ullad Bhagyanath Menon. Hi, Jayanti. Good to see you. Ullad Bhagyanath Menon. And we have Ashutosh Shekhar sending, good evening, ma'am. Kausal Malladi, so nice to see the legend. Deepa S. Manohar, wow, 8th of practice, Guruji. So I'll be including more comments gradually. But Jayanti ji, tell me something. It is generally believed, the perception is that Veena is no longer that, has that importance which existed earlier, and there's a dearth of good veena players. What is your opinion about it?
I completely disagree with that. So the veena has always been, first of all, the veena is the national instrument of India, and it has had its importance. The Carnatic music system has originated from the veena. It is the mother of all instruments, and we have always had very great legends playing the veena. We didn't have too many. We had few, but they were all excellent. And as far as the future of veena is concerned, it is in absolutely safe hands. We have a very wonderful breed of young veena players who are doing amazing things nowadays. And veena is not like one of those instruments which is like, you know, puja mein jab hota tha, ab nahi ho raha hai. It's like rocking. There are very, very wonderful young veena players, and it's a very happening instrument now. Just look at it. I mean, how can you not think it's grand and it represents India and the way it looks?
So, when you use the word rocking, so mere man mein ek sawal aaya. Of course, I have seen veena rocking on Mission Impossible. So those audience who have missed, can we have a glimpse of something like that?
No, I'm doing a fun series with different popular tunes. I'm not going to play Mission Impossible now, but we did something like. This is Furelis. This is not exactly Furelis. It's not having the harmonies. It's not having, but just a little bit. We did Pirates of the Caribbean. We did Harry Potter. We did Pink Panther. We did James Bond, and quite a lot of things. Basically, why did we do? Did we do a cover? No, we didn't do a cover. What we did was say that whatever is cool in today's world can be done on the Veena and connected to our Shastriya Sangeet, to our rags, to our thalas. And basically everything is seven notes. And it is in how you see it. Many people watched that series and they picked up their own Veenas and they tried these melodies and found out how cool it is.
Of course, that is why you've taken Veena worldwide, and that is why you are a part of the New York press release, 100 most influential people from UK, EU and Asia. So your name...
You're completely updated, Shwetaji. How do you get the latest information like this?
I want to wish you and congratulate you on this from all my viewers' side.
Thank you so much.
So the general perception we were talking, she says Veena rocks. Okay, so how many of us know the instrument closely? We just know Veena. So we would request the artist to explain why they say it looks like a human body. It has 24 yeah. breaths and it has a dragon head. So would you like to explain the instrument so that, because many of the music lovers join us daily and they would yeah. be happy to know about the instrument.
Surely. So Veena has changed in size, structure, shape, sound a lot in the last 2000 years. I'm just saying 2000, right from the Vedic times we've had the Veena. This particular structure of the Saraswati Veena has been existing for the last, I would say, 350 to 400 years. And this is designed like the human body. So with the head, I'll try and show it to you. I'm sure you all have seen. This is the spinal cord. We have 24 frets. See, basically in the human spinal cord, the neck has 7 vertebrae. Upper back has 12 vertebrae. And the lower back has 5. So that adds up to 24. So which represents exactly on the fretboard of the Veena, we have 24 frets. And then we have the lower part. And then you have the dragon head here. And these frets are made out of honeybees' wax, and it is fixed. The main instrument is made out of jackfruit tree wood. And this is the main resonator, and this is the secondary resonator. Whatever you can't see in this frame, you can see in all the Veenas behind. And these frets are made out of brass, and the strings are made out of steel. And we use the pressure of... So that's how you play the instrument.
But the instrument is such, so big in size, and we can see the viewers who are not able to see the entire instrument in your lap, they can see behind in the backdrop. But how do you travel with this instrument? What are the special care that needs to be taken? Because
mantra, Shwetaji. I have a secret mantra. Once I chant it, Veena becomes this size. I put it in my purse and take it.
A hard case for it.
Yeah. So I have all kinds of cases for it. Initially, we used to have these huge boxes in which it used to come. Then we started having these fiberglass cases where we would put the veena and check it in, and through the flight keep our fingers crossed and hope. You don't know if the concert is on or not until it comes on the baggage belt, and you open it and you see, oh my God, my baby's fine. So, and then now my Guruji has designed another veena where I can take it with me into the flight. So whatever are the decorative elements in this veena, I remove that, and there is a nice, it looks like a banjo now, and it is cabin specific. I don't know after COVID whether they let me do that, but for so many years, at least for the last 20 years, I've been putting it in the cabin. So I'm happy that the veena is in a good place. I used to feel terrible, you know, sitting nicely inside the plane when my veena, who's the main reason for my trip, is somewhere in the baggage in cold. So
yeah, many of the artists have complained that while they land at the particular destination before their concert, they find their instrument in pieces. So
yeah,
it is actually really sad to see it happening. But there's no option then to put it in the cargo.
We can, you know, some airlines, like I think it's Delta, it allows us to buy a seat for our instrument. So you can keep it next to you. Not all airlines allow that.
So when you ask the organizer for a ticket, you ask for 2 tickets.
I can ask only for one. I buy the other one.
I'm so sorry.
No, soon people will they'll do it.
I think so. Yes, I think they should do it.
When I used to go in train earlier, Shwetaji, I used to buy 2 tickets. One, my name and my age. One would be Veena, female, age 35. So I would put this and I'll nicely cover it. And the TTR, he'll ask, I'll say Veena, 35. You know, your ticket is paid for.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, you can do that. That's a brilliant idea.
Yeah.
So tell me something. You started learning in Tanjavur style. There are 4 different styles. And then did you switch further to different styles of playing?
My Guruji never made me aware of the demarcations of style. While teaching me, she never said, oh, this is Mysore style, this is Andhra, this is Trivandrum style, this is Tanjavur style. Basically, she taught me in what is known as a Gayaki Ang. I mean, play like you sing. And more than anything, find the voice of the veena. Find the voice of the instrument. Because the minute you put yourself into a style, it limits you. It puts a wall around you and it says, oh, I won't play that because that is not my style. So, of course, these 4 styles are existing. It's very beautiful. There's a beautiful right-hand work in the Andhra style. There's a beautiful, the Mysore style, they don't use these pluck drums. They have a beautiful left-hand technique. Tanjavur style has a lot of gamak. And Trivandrum style is a lot like Tanjavur style. Beautiful and authoritative playing. There is the demarcation. But now I see as generations go by, the boundaries between styles are blending and people want to just play the instrument, not be so conscious about what style am I playing.
Yeah. So well, let me include some of the comments. We have Shireen Sen Gupta Nath, the vocalist, Ranajit Sen Gupta's wife. She's a vocalist.
Wonderful.
Wonderfully played, Jayanti Ji. And we have Nandini Chandrasekhar, ma'am appeals to all age groups. And we have Shivani Devuru sending smiles. Yes.
Yeah.
We have Ullath Bhagyanath Menon writing very enlightening, great. We have Madhurani Singh enjoying the conversation, writing very nice. Prajna Adiga, Indian classical music is a huge ocean. It's cooler and attractive than any other form of music. No other opinion on that. How beautiful. So I would be including more comments gradually. And we have a very regular dedicated viewer, Dinesh Vaidya, writing, ha 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 ha, Veena gets a ticket.
Not okay. A speeding ticket, only ticket in the train.
Right. So we see a lot of reflection of Hindustani classical music on in your performances, Jayanti Ji. How does that happen?
I think for every musician, we start off playing one type of style. And then in your journey, it's like life, Shweta ji. See, everything, our influences are from our friends, from our family, from our social, cultural, ecological, people we move with. So imagine you have a Malayali friend and so much of that Malayalam rubs on into you, doesn't it? Like that, I interact a lot with my counterparts in Hindustani system. And I have a great amount of respect for what they do, and it's mutual. Because of playing so much, I think some of that has rubbed off on me. And I listen to a lot of Hindustani music also. So I think this evolution, the style is something that is evolving. It's not etched in stone. I think it keeps evolving as time goes.
Right. So a very, very special composition that is close to your heart, what truly reflects Jayanti Koharesh. We'd like to hear something, a small composition, a small piece from your side.
I won't play a composition. I'll just play a little what we call as Thanam.
Okay.
It's like the Jod and Jala of the Hindustani system. Yeah.
Instrument.
I think it's practice. So much so that even if I'm on long flights, after the first 1 hour, I'll sit cross-legged. I can't sit with my feet down for a very long time. I'm so used to this Padmasana. Wherever I sit, I'll sit like this.
Wow, beautiful. So, aisa kehte hain ki Saraswati Veena jo hai, ये हिंदुस्तान के सबसे पुराने साजों में से एक है और जितनी भी श्रुतियां हैं सब सबका जन्म जो है वो वीणा से ही हुआ है. सो इफ यू कैन elaborate more on this, I would also be, along with viewers, would be able to enhance my knowledge on this.
See, basically, any string instrument is called a veena. Okay? Vanyante iti veena. That which can be played is veena. So much so, voice is called gatra veena. Human body is called sharira veena. Violin is called dhanur veena. Santur is called Shatatantri Veena. We have Rudra Veena, we have Chitra Veena, we have Vichitra Veena, we have Mayura Veena, we have Matsya Veena, we have Hamsa Veena. So every type of instrument. In the north, you have Rudra Veena, don't you? So with two pumpkin goats like that, a bigger instrument, one octave lower.
It is held also.
Yeah, and any instrument, this instrument was used initially as an accompaniment to Samaved. The first we hear about, mention about it, is when the Samaveda was chanted by the males, the women used to play on an instrument called Adambari, and it was, the string was made out of grass. That is the first instrument. Then we had one string instrument, Ektari, then two string, Dotari, then three Tritantrika, then we had Ek Rag Mel Veena, only 7 frets, then Dvi Rag Mel Veena, and then we had the 24 frets Veena. So the evolution is happening as time passes. Today we have electronic Veena, we have digital Veena with a MIDI mix, and we have all these wonderful.
You enjoy playing on those electronic gadgets, Veenas or instruments, or you are still stuck to the original Veena?
I like to try everything, but my concerts, I play on this. It's like, it's kind of become like my own baby. So I like everybody else's, but mine is.
Nice. No, of course, I think one gets habituated also using a particular instrument, and you're more comfortable using that.
Shall yes, I? Like every instrument has an intrinsic spirit. You find, you kind of create a bond with that instrument. Which is why, even for when I travel, there may be a veena in, let's say, Canada. There may be a veena, but I'd like to take my veena because I have formed a relationship with it, a bond with it. And I know what I should do, how I should maneuver this to make it sound nice.
How is it when you do a concert with your husband on the stage?
Oh, we call it strings attached. That is a lot of fun. And we try and create our own compositions. See, he comes from a different school, Garana of playing, and mine is different. So instead of retuning whatever we have already learned, we create compositions exclusively called strings attached. And we have a lot of fun playing it. There is continuity in the violin. There is loudness in the violin. There is silence in the veena. And there is gamak in the veena.
On the stage also, he overpowers and overrules.
Nothing like that. You remember, I come in the 100 most influential people of the world. So I kind of have some influence on him.
Right. So we have Dinesh Vaidya writing, playing veena in Carnatic style and Hindustani classical style. Is the veena absolutely same, or there are some changes done? He has a question.
Yeah, see, if it is Saraswati Veena, it is the same. But if it is Rudra Veena, that is a totally different instrument. So if you want to play Hindustani on Saraswati Veena, you don't have to do any changes. You just play the music, that's all. But if you want to play the North Indian equivalent of the Saraswati Veena, then you have to play the Rudra Veena.
Right. Only thing is, you need to hold the two Veenas differently. Rudra and Saraswati Veena, they are held differently.
Yeah. See, earlier they used to have they used to hold the veena in this urdhva style, keeping it vertically like this, and now like this. Now, of course, even Rudra Veena players keep it like this, horizontal.
So we have another question. Jayadev B. Menon writes, "Hi, do you find rap music interesting?"
I find every kind of music interesting. I find really every kind of music. And in sometimes when we talk, trying to convince someone, that itself sounds like rap to me. And I absolutely enjoy every kind of music.
Of course. So I will just request a minute from you, Jayantiji. I would like to tell the viewers about the concert which is being organized tomorrow. Firstly, I would request the viewers to like the page and stay connected, because such interesting conversations we have every week for you, and you can meet and interact with brilliant artists across the globe. And tomorrow you can enroll yourself for a virtual concert by Veda, where Ratul Shankar and his team would be performing. And ये भी मैं बता दूँ दर्शकों को कि ये खास कार्यक्रम ना सिर्फ करगिल विजय दिवस पर, जहाँ भारत ने फतह हासिल की थी 99 में, उसको लेकर हो रहा है, सेना के जवानों को सलाम करने के लिए हो रहा है, बल्कि इससे जो फंड रेज होगा वो आज जो देश की हालात है, जिस मजबूरी में है हमारे कलाकार, उनकी मदद के लिए इस्तेमाल किया जाएगा. सो प्लीज आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट द व्यूअर्स टू सपोर्ट इन दिस कॉज. और जयंती जी, आई एम सो सॉरी, एक ये कॉज है क्योंकि कलाकारों की हालत आजकल थोड़ी बिगड़ी हुई है. यू मस्ट बी वॉचिंग इट वेरी क्लोजली. And
not watching, we're all going through this, Shweta ji. All our tours are cancelled, all our concerts are cancelled. I think entertainment industry has been very, very roughly hit. We are all used to traveling, being on stage and doing shows. So at least some of us are able to manage, but there are so many people who depend on temple festivals, who depend on outside public performances alone. And I think that support is absolutely required. If you want your artists back, when once this entire thing is over, we need to support them now.
क्योंकि मुझे ये लगता है कि जिस तरह जो सेना के जवान हैं, भारत हिंदुस्तान की रक्षा करते हैं सरहद पर, उसी तरह जो कलाकार हैं वो हमारे देश की शान है और वो कलाकारिंस हैं. क्योंकि दूसरे देश
की शक्ति है. That is the crux of the cultural thing of the country. So unless we do something to protect that, tomorrow COVID will be over, and then what is the quality of life you will have if there are no artists?
Right.
I'm so really glad you're doing this, Shweta ji. Congrats to you.
Thank you so much. So before we close the show, Jayanti ji, we have so much information on Veena, and can we request for a final presentation from you? Because I didn't want to, but it's like, I think viewers would be also enjoying, and there has been very
little. One line.
Done, done, done. How beautiful, bahut sundar.
Thank you, Shweta ji. It was so much fun chatting up with you.
Aur hamare saath is waqt judi hain Sukanya Ramgopal ji. So
she's such a great artist, such a great gatam. Vidushi. Yeah. Have you had her on your show?
Yes, yes. And I'm just in love with her. And she tells me that she enjoys watching me regularly. And she makes sure she comes to my shows. I really admire her and thankful to her for supporting me. And we have another person, Rama Sandiran Indiran. Writing Vanakkam from Reunion Island. Very nice to listen your Veena playing, he writes.
We were supposed to perform in Reunion Island in August this year, but yeah. So Vanakkam to him, and Vanakkam to all the great musicians. Sukanya ji, so seeking your blessings.
Sukanya ji to very favorite hai. And we have Shankar Narayanan Subramanian joining us. He's a mridangam artist joining us from Mumbai. So thank you.
Namaste ji. Namaste. What a pleasure.
Jayanti ji, it was really nice to connect with you, and thank you for taking time out. Before we close the show, I would like to tell the viewers about the artists that we have tomorrow. We have Kamala Shankar ji joining us tomorrow at 6 o'clock, Indian classical slide guitarist. So brilliant artist, please join the show at 6 o'clock in the evening. And after the show, we have this concert planned for you all, which I mentioned earlier, is to help and support the artists who are going through tough times. So please stay tuned to watch us. Thanks a lot. Thank you, Jayanti ji. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a good night. Namaste.
Namaste.